Hi everyone, I'm Mike, a South Florida firefighter, here again with Drone Nerds, and today we are going to demonstrate how to run a waypoint mission on one of my favorite enterprise drones, the DJI M30T. Stay tuned. Running a waypoint mission on this drone is an excellent tool for first responders, firefighters, and police officers anytime we're using it for a long duration event. That event can be a structure fire that's lasting a long time, a hazmat situation, PD using it for surveillance, and it takes the effort off the pilot in command to do other things in the operation and let the drone do the work. So right now I'm in a housing complex with a row of houses straight down to my left here. There's about 12 to 15 houses. If one of these houses caught on fire, it's not too far-fetched with the houses being this close together for the fire to spread rapidly with radiating heat. If this was gonna be a long duration event, or even if this was a commercial complex or something, we can set a waypoint from one end and run it to the other end to keep that eyes in the sky for our command post. So we're gonna take a look at that operation. So right now we're gonna take off the Mavic 30 thermal, we're gonna set a waypoint, and we're gonna let the drone fly from that point A to point B and see how it works. Okay, we have the drone in the air and now it's time to create the waypoint on this line of houses. If I pan to my right, you can see all the houses right there, and we're gonna create a waypoint to run along the houses. So the first thing we're going to do is click the top left on the back arrow, and we're going to get to our main screen. At the top left of this screen, it says create a route. Click on that. Then it has waypoint mapping oblique and linear. We're going to click on waypoint on the left. Then we have set waypoints and live mission record. We're going to set a waypoint. So now it takes us to our map view. You can see the blue triangle where the drone is. You have a couple of the parameters on the right-hand side of the screen in the black box. If I click right below the home screen, it has some of our other parameters. Right here, we can control the speed of the drone. We have the altitude of the drone, which we're gonna do 200 feet. We'll go back. We want the drone to run the route along 200 feet. There we go. Aircraft yaw along the route. We're going to switch this to manual so we have full control of the camera. And you have a couple other parameters, waypoint type, and upon completion, do you want it to return to home or do we want it to return to the start point and hover? We're going to do return to the start point and hover. So we like what we see on that screen. We're going to go back. And now it's time to zoom in and create our waypoints. So there's our drone. We're gonna click the screen right here and you see the S, and that's where the drone's gonna fly and start. Now if I scroll up here, we'll have our second waypoint, which is about 723 feet away. So we're gonna do two waypoints. Then on the left-hand side of the screen, we see our blue triangle. We're going to hit the start, then it takes us to our pre-flight check on the next screen. Now it has some of the other parameters here, our battery life, obstacle avoidance, horizontal sensing. If we like everything we see on this screen, we're going to hit next. Then it takes us to our waypoint route checklist. Now it has a distance of 715 feet, an estimated 1 minute and 53 seconds to do the waypoint, and then it has two waypoints and some of our other parameters. We're gonna hit upload flight mission on the bottom right. Then we are gonna do our waypoint route checklist. We like what we see there and we're gonna hit start.
Moving to start point.
You hear the controller, it says moving to start point. And we can see on the screen, there's the drone. It's going up to the start point now. It's actually going up to that 200 feet because that's where I wanted it to go. We'll flip on the camera view. We can see our line of houses and it's flying over to the start point. So I'm panning the camera down. I'm also watching. I can flip back to the map view. You can see it getting ready to start.
Arrived at start point.
There you go, arrived at the start point. I'm gonna flip back to the camera and I have full control of the drone camera while it is flying along this line of houses. Now, if I switch to my infrared view, there we go. There's my white hot color palette. There's my black hot, and I'm letting the drone do the work all by itself, and I can control other areas of the mission, which I really like. Here's back to the map view. It's flying along this route. And I'm totally just letting the drone do the work and I'm panning the camera. If this were a fire right now or a long duration event, I can concentrate on just running this part of the operation and not doing anything with flying the drone. So the drone's flying along the waypoint. There we go, it's about two-thirds of the way through to the end. And I am monitoring everything with the thermal imaging camera on this long duration event. Switch my color palettes. There's my iron red. And this is good for any, you know, warehouse, commercial building, a long hazmat situation. If PD is trying to monitor an area and do some kind of surveillance, this is good. I like this. I don't have any stress on actually flying the drone. I'm just kind of monitoring the camera. Now we can see it arrived at the waypoint and it's actually heading back along the route to come back to the starting point.
So this has been a demonstration of the M30T running a waypoint mission. I think this is a phenomenal option for first responders, firefighters, and police officers for any long duration emergency. The drone does all the work and lets you focus on other areas of the operation. If you have any further questions or comments, contact us at experts@dronenerds.com or leave a comment below. Once again, I'm Mike. Have a nice day.